Hello, my wonderful viewers, welcome back to my channel. It's a moment at which Biafrans are in the mood of achieving their mission. And what is our mission? The end point is restoration of Biafra. But for now, we want our leader, Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu, to be out. And we know that we had taken a very good action last week Monday that shook the foundation of Nigeria. In fact, I don't need to go into that again because you all observe what really happened. But now, according to the news from DOS, that is Directorate of State, they have shifted or they have suspended the sit-at-home order, which is supposed to take place tomorrow being Monday. So they have a reason for that, and that reason is what I want to give to you right now. And after which, after reading the press statement, we can as well analyze the issue. So let me go. But before then, please, if you're new to my channel, thank you for coming by. Please subscribe before you leave. See, like, press that like so that this news will also get to other people. Share as much as you can. God will bless you as you do so. To my old subscribers, I thank you so much for being part of this, and God will bless you too. So let me go. While we are reviewing the Monday the indefinite sit-at-home order, IPOB, that's the caption. The leadership of the Indigenous People of Biafra, IPOB, understands the concern being expressed by the global IPOB family on the suspension of the weekly sit-at-home earlier announced by the IPOB head of Directorate of State of the Indigenous People of Biafra. We know that our people embrace this civil action wholeheartedly and without any compulsion. The leadership sincerely appreciate the innate desire of Biafrans to sacrifice their time, resources, and energy in ensuring that our leader, Onyendu Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu, is released unconditionally from the illegal custody of the Nigerian state, who criminally renditioned him from Kenya to Nigeria. The suspension of the sit-at-home by IPOB head of directorate was as a result of a direct order from the leader of this great movement, Onyendu Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu. There is no gainsaying that the fact that one of the major fundamental guiding principles of IPOB is command and control. This simply means that all command from the supreme leader of the Indigenous People of Biafra, IPOB, will be obeyed and implemented to the letter by the Directorate of State of the Indigenous People of Biafra. Bearing in mind, therefore, that this principle has enabled this movement to surpass even the expectations of both Biafrans and non-Biafrans alike, the leadership wish to encourage Biafran to focus on the most pressing issue confronting this great family presently, which is ensuring the safety of our leader while still in the illegal custody of the DSS, and to secure his unconditional release from detention. In accordance with the directive from our leader, our sit-at-home will in the meantime be observed on the date of our leader's court appearances. The IPOB leadership urged Biafrans worldwide to take note of the next court appearance of our leader, which is the 21st of October 2021. If, however, we have any reason or directive from the IPOB highest command that requires us to reactivate the suspended weekly sit-at-home, the leadership will not hesitate to lift the suspension and continue with the civil action. The leadership once more appreciate all Biafrans and our friends and sympathizers who faithfully observed the Monday, August 9th sit-at-home, which was a huge success throughout Biafra land. May God continue to bless and uphold all those committed to our struggle. We consider Biafran restoration as a sacrosanct call to duty above all else. Any other information regarding sit at home in Biafra land is not emanating from IPOB through our main channels of information dissemination should be disregarded. The Nigerian government should heed now to the voice of reason coming from within Nigeria and from outside the shores of Nigeria to unconditionally free our leader Mazen Nnamdi Kanu and announce a date for Biafra referendum or plebiscite where our people will choose where they wish to belong before it is too late. This is a publication by Comrade Emma Powerful, the media and publicity secretary for IPOB. Yes, this is the reason why it was suspended. You can understand that this directive comes from the leader of indigenous people of Biafra, Nnamdi Kanu himself. And according to this information, it is not that sit at home is cancelled. No. It can be reactivated at any time. Any time it can be reactivated. But for the one coming on tomorrow, which is 16th, it has been suspended. Well, I know that Biafrans are unhappy, including myself. When I got the news, I was shocked. I couldn't even fathom it. I couldn't even believe that they could do such a thing. The DOSS could suspend this very effective weapon we had in our hand. It shook that country. We use it to tell the world for the first time that we are ready to leave Nigeria. Yes, we've had sit at home before, but remember, that was to for remembrance of those who died during the 1967 to 1971 war, Biafran war. So it was a remembrance day for the millions killed by the Nigerian government. So that of 9th of August was the first time we did sit at home in respect of our agitation to be free, to have a referendum, and also for our leader to be released. That is the first time we did this. And it shook the government. It proved to the world that we are ready, that we love our leader, and that we want to be on our own. We need self-determination. Which is also the time we prove to the leaders, the people they call leaders, that is the politicians, the governors, the Ohanazes, that we, the people, owns the power. The power belongs to us. We have proved to the world that Nnamdi Kanu is not alone in this struggle, that he is the leader of over 70 million Biafrans who are in support of his movement, and that Nigerian government holding him is holding over 70 million people in detention, and he must be released so that we all can be released at the same time. We are able to prove to the world that when we decide that we can cripple the economy of Nigeria, that it's a possibility without fighting it's a single war. Without shooting a bullet, we have proved it through the sit at home. We have equally proved to the world that despite the detention of our leader, that the movement will still go on. Nobody can stop it. Nobody can stop it. So the better they release him, the better for all of us. Biafrans are really angry. Surely, that this sit at home, which is a weapon we have in our hand to fight back against the detention of our leader, or to show to the Nigerian government that we have something we can do, that it was being suspended. Well, everybody is unhappy. I would say 99.9% of Biafrans are not happy with DOS, that is the Directorate of State. However, the modus operandi of IPOB is based on command and control. So, it's the DOS that told us we have to sit at home on the night to press for the release of our leader. We obeyed. It's also the same DOS that told us that we have to suspend. I'm begging and pleading to my Biafrans. Those who are angry, those who said impossible, we will continue to their agitation by sitting at home on Monday, to please understand that the order also came from the same DOS. We know that everybody is in pain. We know the potent of this sit at home, how it has shook the foundation, how it shook Nigeria and the politicians. We know. But the DOS also know this. They said, hold on. Just hold on. Do you know whether they still have a more stronger means we can hit on these people that will compel them to release our leader immediately? We don't know, because they are the one privy to information. So, like I said, let us support the DOS so that this command and control is not going to fail. This command and control is not going to lose its potent. Please, let us still obey the DOS. I thank you for listening as we await the directives from DOS. See you again in my next video.